Welcome to Office 2013, class video number 35. Hey, if you want to download this workbook, and this workbook is for videos 35 to 38, click on the link below the video or go to our class website. Hey, we're still studying Excel. This is Excel Basics number 17, and we have a great video here because we're going to see how to search for Excel function. And we have two examples. We're going to learn about the PMT function and the median function. Now, here's the deal. Excel is supposed to make our lives easier, right? So our first example, this is a finance example. And our goal is to calculate the monthly payment. Here's the price of the car. Here's the down payment. Here's the quoted annual interest rate. And the loan is going to be for 5 years. Now, before we go about the complicated task of calculating this monthly payment, we actually have to do some pre-calculations. So for example, that's the price for the car. If there's a down payment of $10,000, we have to figure out how much the loan is. So we'll do a formula, equals, and I'm going to get the price of the car minus the down payment. Control Enter. $24,799. And the nice thing about building a template like this, of course, if we change this to 5,000, boom, our loan amount instantly updates. Control Z. The next calculation is, well, they give us the annual rate, but if we're calculating a monthly payment, we need to calculate the monthly interest rate. Now, if this is for the whole year, and there's 12 months in the year, then of course we need to chop that into 12 pieces. So equals 4.8% divided by 12. Now that's an example of a number that's not going to change. 12 months in a year is not going to change. So we can simply type it into our formula. Enter. So 0.4% will be our monthly interest rate. Now next we need total months. Anytime you're calculating a loan payment, whatever the period, this happens to be months, you have to figure out how many total periods. Well, OK, so 5 years, 12 months in each year, so equals 5 times 12. That number can change in our template. That number is not going to change. So we simply use a number there, use a cell reference for the years. If we were to change this to 3, instantly it would update. Control Z. Now we have all of our formula inputs to calculate a loan payment. Now here's where the beauty of searching for a function comes in. This is the formula. I'm in B13F2. That's the formula to calculate a loan payment. Now this is a famous finance function for an annuity. But even if you knew this function and you were a finance person, there's a much easier way. So here's the deal. We click in the cell where we want the function to go, and we can search. Now there is a keyboard shortcut, Shift F3. I don't usually use that one, but that will open the Insert Function dialog box. Right next to the formula bar here, Insert Function, I can click on that. That's called the F of X. That's from algebra. F of X button, boop, and there it is, Insert Function. Now I can type something and then click Go. So I'm going to type, how about monthly loan payment, and then hit Enter or click Go. And so it'll give you a list of functions. And sometimes you have to click through each one and read the description. So the first one, PV, returns the present value of an investment. Well, that doesn't sound like it. PMT, calculates the payment for a loan based on constant payments and a constant interest rate. Hey, that sounds like it. So you click through after you search. When you find the one you want, you click OK. Now this Functions Argument dialog box is great because there are sometimes, like with this function, many arguments to enter. You can click through each one and it will have a description of what should go there. So let's read it. Rate is the interest rate per period for the loan. For example, use 6% divided by 4 for quarterly payments at 6%. Annual percentage rate. So sometimes it gives you pretty good hints. Now we already did our division. We were smart, right? So the rate. Now this is a text box. That's the collapse button. Anytime you see that collapse button, it means you can connect the text box to the cells. Now I'm going to drag it out of the way here. With the rate, I'm going to click on monthly, not annual. The banker would love it if you calculated the monthly rate with the annual rate, because then it would be huge. Use monthly rate. The rule of thumb for a function like this, and this is one of the many finance functions, is all of the arguments have to be in the same period. So we're doing month, so I'm going to use the monthly rate. NPER is the total number of payments for the loan. Oh, OK, so we already calculate that. Number periods, that's what that stands for. So I'm going to click in that text box. Not five, it's total number of periods. Remember, we're doing monthly payment for our loan, so everything has to be in months. Now, PV is the present value. The total amount of a series of future payments is worth now. Now, that's finance speak. You got to just think of present value as, hey, if I go borrow $24,799 today, what's the present value of it? It just means how much is it worth? Well, $24,000. Now, so I'm going to click. Boop. Now, notice over here, you can see, oh, the unformatted numbers. So all of these text boxes have cell references, and it's displaying the unformatted numbers over here. Down here, it's showing me the result. There's also a result over here. Now, I click into this next one and this next one. These ones are not bold. You can see bold, bold, bold. These ones are not bold. That means that they're optional. And for us, we don't need to worry about these. If you were a finance person, you would have to worry about those. All right, so you ready? Here's the magic. I'm going to click OK. Oh, that is amazing. Now, that looks like number formatting. We talked about before, that's either accounting or currency. Oh no, we know exactly which one it is. It's currency, because the dollar sign isn't fixed on the outside. Now that is red, and it's got parentheses, so I'm going to use the keyboard Control 1 to open up the format cells. Go to number, and in currency, I'm going to select negative numbers. Click OK. Now, this one down here doesn't have any formatting, so it shows the number and all of its decimals. But why is that negative? If I click in that cell and hit F2, why is the PMT spitting out a negative? Here's the amazing thing. These finance functions, and this is just one of them, they understand cash flow. If you're buying the car, every month you're paying the $465.72, you're actually having this money come out of your wallet. Now, if you take a finance class, you'll learn all about cash flows. But that's another example how the built-in functions really help you. It totally understands cash flow that's important for finance. Now, one other thing. Since this shows all the decimals here, I bet you anything, if we increase the decimals, we'll see these here also. And of course we do. The formula down here, math formula, and the PMT function are calculating the same. Now I'd like to actually hack off and officially round this using the round function. So 7718, that would round to 72 pennies. So I'm going to click in this cell and hit F2. We click after the equal sign but before our PMT. And type round. Now we saw this before. We did a multiplication calculation. The round, and I'm going to click on this screen tip number argument. That thing can be anything. It can be a number from a cell, multiplication like we did before, this function, or even a big, huge formula calculation thing. Whatever it is, come to the end, type comma, and num digits. That means what position do you want to round to? As we studied before, penny is 2. Close parentheses, Control Enter. Now I'm going to decrease those decimals. From our earlier keyboard video, we know that I set up my keyboard QWAT to do Alt 1, so I can Alt 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Oh, that's beautiful. So now we have $465.72, that's our monthly payment, and the PMT really made our job easy. One last thing for this little template before we test it. We're going to test all the inputs and see if everything updates. I'd like a label at the top. I'd actually like the label to say the monthly payment is, and have this a formula that looks down here. So when I change these inputs, the label at the top will change also. A8, hit F2, and then I'm going to put my cursor at the very beginning. And if we want text in a formula, as we learned last video, you have to put it in double quotes. Oh, but we want it to be a formula. Equal sign tells it the cell this is a formula. Double quotes, the space, the monthly payment is, and I'm going to come to the end and double click those question mark, type a double quote, and now I want to join this bit of text to this cell down here. So I'm going to use the ampersand Shift-7, that's the join symbol, and then click on this cell reference B12. Now, if you're paying attention and studying hard in this class, that's a cell reference. And if that's number formatting, this formula sure is not going to look at that number formatting. So when I Control Enter, no, it's not looking at the number formatting. Now, there's a few ways we could make this label more appealing. I'm going to click in the cell and hit F2. First thing is, I don't want it showing up as a negative for my label. Finance is beautiful. It's showing up negative down here. So I'm just going to, in this text formula here, type a minus sign in front of it. Double negative, a minus, minus, or the opposite of a negative or a double negative will turn it positive. So if I Control Enter, it's positive. Now, one last thing, F2, let's add a dollar sign. But I can't add the dollar sign here. Since it's going to be text, I have to add it somewhere in here. Now, notice we were smart. We put a space there so that there's a space between is and the number. But I don't want the dollar sign to have a space between it and the number. So F2, I actually put the dollar sign right there. Now, this gets tricky doing these text formulas. And the way I usually hack my way through it is I make a mistake, right? I accidentally type a dollar sign, and then I enter it, and I'm like, oh, wait a second, that's not right. And then I F2, and I go back and forth until I get it right. All right, so I'm going to backspace. Maybe this will do it. All right, so that's pretty cool. And here's the really cool part. If I change the down payment to $2,000, boom, instantly everything updates, including my label at the top. That's just beautiful. If I change the price of the car, oh, wait a second, I only have $24,000. Instantly the label and our beautiful round PMT function works down here. All right, so the bottom line is I don't want to do all of that. I certainly like the PMD. And then we remember from our earlier discussions of round and a text formula, pretty cool. Now we have another example of when you want to probably find an easier way to do something, and hopefully they have a built-in function. We have a bunch of house prices here. Now, let's remember back to our keyboard video. I don't know how tall this is, so I'm going to use Control down arrow. Whoa, 10,000 numbers, Control up arrow. And then scroll a little bit. So we have a data dump of like housing prices from our area of the state, over 10,000 numbers. And we want to calculate an average. Now, most of us think of an average, arithmetic mean. We add them all up and divide by the count. But there's lots of different kinds of averages. Now, if you've ever heard a real estate agent talk about houses, their typical value they use is not arithmetic mean. They don't add them all up and divide by the count. They always say, hey, the median price is. Well, averages just means a typical value. If you're advertising or a real estate agent, you need one number to represent all the data points to say something about that neighborhood. Hey, the average price is blank. So an average is one number that represents all the numbers. Well, the problem with arithmetic mean, when it adds them all up and divides by the count, is it uses all of them. If there's $1 million house, and I'm going to click in this and Control down arrow, if you so it's not sorted. But you could see if there's a few really expensive houses and the rest are not very expensive, I clicked and then Control up arrow. That would make your average or mean calculation bigger than it should be. And that's actually why real estate agents use the median. Let's first search for a function that will calculate average. Well, we're not going to do that because we already did that earlier in the class. We know that it's the average. So the people who designed spreadsheets did not use the word mean. That is the word from statistics. But mean is technically the word that describes adding them all up and dividing by the count. But the function in Excel is average. So all right, I'm going to click and remember my keyboard shortcut, Control Shift Down Arrow. I love it. I don't have to drag my cursor down 10,000 rows. Now I'm going to hit Enter. If I hit Enter, it goes down, right, and jumps the screen back up, but not quite high enough. So if the real estate agent wanted to use this number, they'd say the average house is $460,000 approximately. Now median. Let's just see how we'd have to do this by hand. This is terrible. You actually have to sort the list of numbers and find the one in the middle. So for this huge data set, I don't even know how to do that. I'd have to do it. It'd be terrible. First, I'd have to count. Then I'd have to divide by 2. We'd have to look up that one and then look up the one after it. And then we'd have to take those two because there is an even number and average those to get the median. I never want to do that. So luckily, because that's the median right there. Luckily, there's a built-in function. So the idea is they put functions in that make our life easy as Excel users. So I'm going to click in this cell and click on the F of X and type, well, I know the name of this one, median. And I hit Enter instead of clicking Go. And right at the top, it's called median. It's a very common calculation. Returns the median, or the number in the middle of a set given numbers. Oh, that is so cool. So I click OK. It's trying to guess. We talked about this earlier when we did like the sum function, but sometimes it does that in the function argument dialog box also. So click in the top cell, Control Shift Down Arrow, and then I'm going to click OK. That is amazing and a lot easier than this calculation we did over here. And we can see the median in terms of the real estate agent. This number is a lot smaller than the arithmetic mean. The arithmetic mean had those million-dollar houses included, so it made this number bigger. Perhaps this number represents the neighborhood better than the average calculation. All right, so median, and we saw PMT. Sometimes searching for built-in functions can make our calculating job a lot easier. All right, we'll see you next video.